In this movie, I wanted to talk about the importance of compound paths and how they relate to clipping masks in a way that you might not have thought about before. So I've made just a series of shapes here. And by the way, I came up with colors just by using color guide. I selected a color here, and then I opened up color guide, and it actually suggested some colors for me. Based off of this initial color that I had. So if you ever want to just come up with a color combination and you don't like the colors that you're thinking up, color guide is sometimes a good cheat. But anyway, let's say I wanted to clip out these items, but I wanted to do something kind of non-conventional or unconventional, I guess is the term. I've made here a grid of boxes. And I just want everything to get clipped inside of this grid so that it'll just show through this little grid. So I made it on a separate layer just so that it's easy to control. And I want to show you what happens if you normally do this. I'm gonna select the group. So I'm just selecting everything here, and I'm gonna make a clipping mask just conventionally. Clipping mask make. And it's really weird. What happens is the topmost item, which in this case ended up being the last square that was option copied, everything gets clipped by that item, which, since that item was outside of anything that was colorful, ends up being nothing. Now, if we look inside here, notice there's a group, and there's our clipping path, and here's everything else. So that's obviously not what we want. So instead, we want this whole object. Or this whole group of objects to be treated as one object. Now you would think maybe that you could take this whole set of objects and just group them. If I go under Object, Group, then it seems like they're all one thing. Let's try it again. Just select the whole thing. Gives you a warning. But it still doesn't work. And the fact of the matter is even when it's a group, inside that group is a whole bunch of items, and it's still going to be the top item that acts as the clipper. So I'm going to undo that again. So don't fall into this trap of thinking that just because you're making something into a group, you're making them all on the same level. To make them all on the same level, we have to turn them into a compound path. So I'm going to, again, just select that entire group of objects. Go under Object to Compound Path and make a compound path. Notice when I do that, it becomes one object. Now I'm going to select it and the background shapes and choose Clipping Mask. I'll still get the warning that it's very complex. And by the way, this brings up a whole other issue. At a certain point, Illustrator gives you plenty of rope to cause problems for yourself. Remember that you should always test things out before you take them off to print. Print to a PostScript printer that's black and white before you take a job in to get it color printed on a PostScript printer. Or do that before you get it printed to offset press. It's always good to double check on another type of equipment that's similar in technology just to make sure it works. Okay, so I'm going to just say okay and hope for the best. And when I do, notice the difference now. Now that design shows up inside of this grid work that I've made. So that's an example of where a compound path is useful. The other thing that you'll notice about this, just in terms of layer structure, is you can't have clipping masks that go across layers. So whenever you select items across layers and they're going to get clipped, they're automatically going to become a group. Groups can't be across layers, so they're always going to jump to the same layer as the clipping item, which would be the top layer of the selection. So there you go. This is kind of a neat way of creating some interesting artwork. And it's very complex to do by hand, something like this, but pretty easy in the world of Illustrator. So keep that in mind.